Hey guys, so now that I'm done looking like a bad Snapchat filter, I can film the intro for this video. I was gonna put on my face, but I figured, what is the point? This is a skincare related video. There's plenty of videos with my face, makeup face already on. So we're just gonna go fresh faced. I'm really happy with how my skin is lately. Since I was on my Curology kick, which I still am on it, my face cleared up and it's looking really, really good, which I'm happy about. So I wanted to do a fun video showing you guys a bunch of different type of masks. These aren't like your typical sheet masks. These are masks with different consistencies, and pretty much I'm gonna show you some of this. I only did a handful of them for this video because I didn't want to be too long, but I have other similar masks like a different type of peel off, which I have for another video, and some other clay masks that are pretty cool. So if you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up and I will do a part two of this video with more masks. So without further ado, let's just get started, shall we? So the first mask I'm gonna show you guys today is by Elizabeca. I love their mask. I have a lot of their masks and they're awesome. This is a jelly pack mask and it has gold Nest collagen, so it's really good for firming and moisturizing. The packaging is to die for. It's super, super cute. So the mask looks like a white cream. As you apply it, it starts to turn clear. So the directions tell you to apply just an even layer. It doesn't say thin or thick, and it's a peel-off type, so you don't have to worry about washing it off. So I would say work decently fast because it does start to dry. I didn't have to worry about applying like a thick barrier so I'd be able to pull it with this mask. It just blended very, very well. This mask is one of the few in this video that are from Mimi Box, and they have an amazing selection of Elizabeca masks. And this is probably one of the pricier masks I'm showing in the video. Otherwise, they are pretty much very affordable. The mask itself has a very thin consistency and it's advised to leave on for 20 to 30 minutes until it is completely dry. I left it on for a good 30 minutes before proceeding with the peeling. And this is supposed to fight wrinkles as well as moisturize and plump the skin. So let's see how it works. The consistency of this mask is definitely sticky. It's very interesting. It starts to kind of ball up and look a little mucousy. It doesn't feel slimy. It just feels like you're peeling off a thin layer of glue if you were the type of kid to like to play with that. But it's a little rubbery, as you can see, in consistency. And I tried to peel it as well as I could in one piece, but it started to spring back to my face. But I did really like how easy it was to remove and clean off. Nothing was too hard to pull or painful at all. My thoughts on the mask is that it's definitely nice for something quick and not too messy. My skin definitely looked moisturized and plumped, and it definitely did make my wrinkles, at least temporarily, look like they went away. I have a little sum on my forehead, but all in all, I would give this mask a 4 out of 5 because the price is a little high. Next mask I picked up at Ulta. This is by Tony Moly. It's the Tightening Cooling Pore Mask, and it is the weirdest consistency. When I opened it, I thought it expired or something like that. So it has like a cottage cheese consistency, and I realized that the best way to do it is to push it into your skin and try to hang on to it, and then as you smooth it out, it becomes like a nice smooth clay. The first time I used it, it was like falling into my sink, but you can grab the little bits and push it against your face and smooth it out. And it's actually a very nice consistency. So don't let the looks fool you and don't think it's expired like I did. So you just apply this all over your face and it's supposed to tighten your pores. I didn't expect much from this mask, honestly. It's one of those I was heading to check out and I saw something cool and I was like, you know what? I love masks and the packaging's cute. Tony Moly always picks up really cool packaging. It retails for $12 and you can get a good amount of uses out of it because a little bit goes a long way. It also removes oil while tightening your pores, so that's nice for someone who has oily, acne skin like myself. You would wait 10 to 15 minutes, however long it takes to dry completely, and then remove it with lukewarm water. And it comes off very nicely, very easy, and it definitely has a good effect. I can see a major difference in my pores right away, and you're supposed to use it twice a week. The effect doesn't last forever, but it is definitely nice to see my pores, especially in my T-zone area, look a lot smaller. So I would highly recommend this mask. I give it a 5 out of 5.
The next mask I'm going to be showing you guys is from the brand Lindsay. They retail for $3 a piece, and I have two different types, but I'm going to be using the hyaluronic acid one, which is the blue packaging. It is a one-time use mask, that's the price being a little bit lower, so let's get started. So it's really cool packaging. It's like a little container, and it has a little water line. So as you can see on the back, it has little pictures, and it has translated instructions. So you pretty much structure the pouch, and you put water into the line that guides you for amount. I definitely was a little confused because if the pouch isn't open properly, then like, is the line kind of wrong? It also has a little spatula on the inside, which made the mask really easy to apply. It can get very messy, so I suggest putting a towel or a tissue down of some sort. This is probably the messiest mask I'm going to show you. So you would mix up the mask into a liquidy gel consistency. It says to make it into a thick gummy texture, so I tried to get it as smooth as possible so it would apply a little easier, but not too watery to the point that I thought it would drip off of my face. The spatula is like a flat spoon shape, and I would suggest working very fast with this mask because it dries super fast, and as it dries, it gets clumpier and harder to spread. So my camera had lighting issues, and I ended up having to wait like 30 seconds and my mask started hardening up. So when I get to my forehead, it's so much harder to spread it. It literally gets really clumpy. So generally, it's gonna be a peel-off mask that's just a gel gummy consistency, and it doesn't hurt. It's definitely one of the more gentle peel-off masks I've ever experienced because of how thick it is. As far as claims go, it's supposed to help moisturize and keep your skin looking supple and have an elastic effect to your skin. It's also supposed to deliver a cooling sensation because it has peppermint extract. It definitely had a little bit of a cool sensation. I don't know if it's from the mask itself or just using like tap water, you know. As you can see, I did my best as far as applying goes. Don't make fun of me, guys. It's really hard. Just make sure you rush when you apply this. This is not one of those masks that you can like look at your phone for a second and think it'll be okay. It won't. But it's definitely a cool experience. I can't wait to try the charcoal one. After about 20 minutes, I started to pull the gel off, and it's a weird feeling. It feels like you're playing or blah, 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 pulling cold Play-Doh off of your face in a way. And I don't know, I've never experienced anything like that. So I'm gonna get to peeling. The smaller bits, as you can see on my forehead, that really, really dried, like the thinner parts, were so hard to remove because they were solid. They were not peeling off easily. I had to kind of like pinch it off and scrape it off a little bit, which sucks. So again, as long as you apply it correctly, you won't have that issue. Otherwise, it should peel off decently clean. I will say it was kind of a pain in the butt to take it off, and that kind of ruined the full experience for me. But as far as effects goes, I think it had less of an effect than the previous mask for sure, but there is a large price difference and they are different consistencies. I would give this mask a 3 out of 5 because it is good for those who have sensitive skin and don't want something that literally pulls and hurts your face. This is very gentle and it's nice to see a variety of a peel-off mask that's also fun to use. The next mask is the most intimidating one for me. It's from April Skin. It's called the Mummy Mud Mask, and it's a different type of mask than I expected because I've tried a mummy mask where you mix things together and then you apply it on your face like the hyaluronic mask I did earlier in the video. But this one is a sheet mask, so it's a little bit easier and a little cleaner, but it's basically a sheet mask that has like a brown essence to it, and it dries like a peel-off mask. So it's like a giant blackhead mask. If that makes any sense, like kind of like a nose strip, that's what it feels like after it's done. So all you do is apply the two-piece mask. You apply the top first and then the bottom over it according to the instructions. You peel off one of the sides and apply it on your face, and you'll see what side you're supposed to apply on your face, because one side is smooth and the other side has like the sticky essence on it. So you apply the sticky essence side to your face and then you wait for it to dry for 30 minutes. I would say it took me about 35 to 40 minutes because the area where the mask meets does not dry all the way, because the bottom layer tries to dry and the top layer keeps it kind of moist, so that area itself doesn't dry as well. So I try to wait like an extra 10 minutes and give it as much time as possible so it could peel off without leaving too much residue. I was terrified because the first time I did a mummy mask, my face was so tight I could not move, and this is no different. This is definitely tight, but not as tight as the other one. The other one was almost painful and itchy. Around 40 minutes, this one started to get a little itchy, and I was like, okay, it has to get off now, guys. It's too tight. That's what she said, or he said, or something. Whatever. This is also from Mimi Box, and it's pretty affordable. It retails for $5 each, which is pretty reasonable. It has Hawaiian clay, and that is what is sticking to your face, and it helps remove oil and impurities while peeling. Aside from the little area that stayed wet on my face, after peeling, you can definitely see that there is a little bit of residue on my face, and all you have to do is remove it with some lukewarm water. And again, it kind of acts like a giant blackhead strip on your face. It doesn't hurt that badly. It definitely has a little pull to it, but it's not unbearable, and it's not something I would like say is super duper painful. My brow hairs did not get stuck to it, if that's what you're wondering. So your brows are safe, ladies. All in all, I would give this mask a 3.5 out of 5 because it is a little messy, and on all of my white furniture, I was terrified that it was gonna stain, like when I would put down like the film that was covering it and stuff. So I'll give it a 3.5. It definitely left me with very soft skin, and I felt like I had a little glow to me. I don't know if all those impurities being removed, but I couldn't really see anything on the mask like you would see something on a nose strip. So let me know what you guys think about it. I was just like, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was. Last but not least for this video, you know I had to add a sheet mask of some sort. I'm like the self-proclaimed sheet mask queen. So this is by Uzu, and this is a face injection mask. I'm sure you guys have seen it somewhere. It is interesting because it's a mask that you inject the serum into before applying it to your face, instead of just buying a sheet mask pouch that already has the serum soaking in the mask. It's supposed to be a good thing that you put the serum on yourself because it, I guess, keeps the ingredients fresher. So the first thing you do is push the top of the syringe down, and it releases stuff into the bottom. As you can see, it's just like a little bit of a serum, and you mix the mixture together, shake it up, and after you do that, you apply it into the sheet mask, and then I like to smooth around my hands a little bit, open it, and apply it to your face. There's definitely a good amount of serum on it. It was dripping like crazy, and you would think in that tiny syringe there wasn't enough, but it was a good amount for sure. And it's probably, no lie, one of the softest masks I have ever tried in my life. It was the most ridiculous, like, silky feeling mask ever. So that itself made me want to get another one, though I don't know if I really care for the fact that you have to inject the serum. It was really comfortable to wear, and I've tried a lot of brands. As far as price goes, it retails for $5 to $6 depending on where you go, and there's two types. There's the Hydro Facelift type, which is the one I'm using, the blue one, and there's also a Illumination one, which I kind of want to try now, that's pink. The mask claims to seal in moisture and prevent wrinkles, and I would think it just did a good job in smoothing out and moisturizing my skin. I definitely liked how my skin looked afterwards, and I, again, am just in love with the texture of the mask. So I would give it a 4 out of 5, because I feel like the whole concept is a little bit extra. I mean, the whole syringe thing, but if it works, it works.
So I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all of these masks. These are really awesome. Blah, 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 blah. No, cut that completely. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. Again, let me know if you guys want a part 2. Just give this video a thumbs up and I'll know. Thank you guys as always for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all the crazy masks. Did I say that already? I think I might have. Got that? Okay. So that is it to the part 1 of this video. If you guys want the part 2, then give me a thumbs up to let me know. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all of these fun masks. They really are pretty cool, and I hope you enjoyed hearing my thoughts on them. So thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in a later video.